Hello friends, under the chapter of refraction, we have studied the Lensmaker's formula, okay, and just we once saw its application, the Lensmaker formula, what will be the change on the Lensmaker's formula when we used to take a biconvex lens, biconcave lens, plano-concave lens, plano-convex lens and convexo-concave lens and convexo-concave lens. And in that we saw that when we use a concave lens, whether it is a biconcave, plano-concave or convexo-concave, its focal length will always be negative. And when we use a convex lens, plano-convex lens, biconvex lens or a concave-convex lens, its focal length will always be positive. Now today we will see one thing in the lens formula itself. What will happen when you dip the lens in some medium, okay. So we saw that in a Lensmaker formula, we have the formula is like this. Okay, this is the formula, we saw that Lensmaker's formula. So what will happen when the particular lens is immersed in a liquid of some refractive index? Then as you know that the refractive index is, N is a refractive index of medium. So when we immerse lens in some other medium, then there will be change in refractive index. Okay. And hence there will be the change in focal length. Okay. That we will see today. Let us consider we have some liquid. Okay. Its refractive index say N liquid with respect to air. And we have a lens material, lens, its refractive index is N, okay. Refractive index of the material of the lens is suppose N. So when this is immersed in a particular liquid, we have a lens and lens is immersed in a particular liquid. So here, then what will be the change in its focal length? See, first, when it is an air, so its focal length, suppose F, will have using the Lensmaker's formula. Okay, now when lens is immersed in liquid, okay, when the lens is immersed in liquid, then we assume that its focal length is suppose F prime. Suppose its focal length is f prime, so we will write 1 upon f prime is equal to n, that is a refractive index of glass, okay. See, refractive index of, this is refractive index of material with respect to the liquid, minus 1, 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r. Here we can say the refractive index of material of the lens, suppose it is glass, so we can take Ng with respect to air. Here the refractive index of liquid with respect to air, so refractive index of liquid with respect to air is A, refractive index of lens material, that is glass, with respect to A. So these things we had to use, okay. So let it be considered initially, so where Ng is what? The refractive index of glass material, index of material of lens, okay, refractive index of liquid. So this we have this relation, see equation 1 and equation 2, okay. Let's see once again. When in the previous two lectures we saw that lens formula, in first we saw its derivation and second we saw how it will be arranged, how it will be described when we use a plano convex lens, convex concavo convex lens and etc. Okay, now today we will see when the lens is immersed in a particular medium, then what is happening. So here 1 upon f equal to n, refractive index of the material of the lens,
within a bracket 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2. This is the formula. So more precisely we can say the refractive index of the material of the lens is Ng with respect to air. So this is the main formula. Here we can write Ng with respect to air. Okay. Now when it is immersed in a particular liquid, then what is happening? Its focal length is changed. So I am telling that new focal length is f prime. So 1 upon f prime is equal to, we can write, n of the refractive index, that is with respect to liquid. Clear? Minus 1 and within bracket the same thing. Now do one thing, to divide one equation by the another equation. So we shall get a equation 1 by equation 2. Divide this by this. Okay, so what shall we get? 1 upon f divided by 1 upon f prime is equal to this whole thing, refractive index of glass with respect to air minus 1, and within a bracket this thing, divided by refractive index of glass with respect to liquid minus 1, and within the bracket the same thing. Clear? Now just see, this term will be cancelled out, same term. Within a bracket 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2, here also the same thing, it will be cancelled out. So what shall we get? So finally just see this thing, 1 upon f divided by 1 upon f prime. So 1 upon f upon 1 upon f prime, here it will be cancelled out. So refractive index of glass with respect to liquid. Now this we can arrange like this, f prime. And you know also one thing, one of the previous lecture we saw that Ng, refractive index of glass with respect to liquid, this we can write refractive index of glass with respect to air divided by refractive index of liquid with respect to air. This we can write like this. Clear? So here we substitute this value here. So what shall we get? Here put this value. So we will get here refractive index of glass with respect to air minus 1, okay, divided by this thing, we can write refractive index of glass with respect to air divided by refractive index of liquid with respect to air whole minus 1, this upon this. Okay, now simplify a little, take the LCM, we get f prime upon f this, just simplify, we'll get this minus divided by this, you can write in numerator. So finally we will get refractive index of liquid with respect to air into refractive index of glass with respect to air divided by refractive index of glass minus refractive index of liquid, both with respect to air. Okay, so finally we will get the formula I am writing here. The f prime is equal to f time, transfer this thing also, the refractive index of liquid with respect to air within a bracket, refractive index of glass with respect to air minus 1 divided by refractive index of glass with respect to air minus refractive index of liquid with respect to air. Clear? So this is the formula we got. Now let's analyze this formula, what will happen. See, just take some values of the refractive index of this liquid. Okay, just assume that the refractive index of the liquid is less than that of the refractive index of material. Okay, so we will take three conditions. First condition, if the refractive index of liquid is less than the refractive index of glass material. The refractive index is less than refractive index of glass material. So what will happen here? This quantity will be positive. This quantity will be positive. So what will happen? Ng is greater, NL is less. Okay. So f prime is positive. Fine. Second case we can take, if it is equal, means the liquid in which you are immersing the lens, its refractive index is exactly equal to the lens. So what will happen? It behaves like a simple glass. Okay, means this term will be cancelled out. Okay, so this becomes 0, Ng minus NL become 0. So we can say here f prime becomes infinity. Okay, this denominator is 0. So the lens behaves like a simple glass or glass slab, you can say. Means there will be no refraction takes place. Clear? Now what will happen, third case, if the refractive index of the liquid material, it is greater than the refractive index of the material of the lens. Then just see, this is less, this is more. This is less, this is more. So this whole thing becomes negative. So here f prime is negative. Okay, f prime is negative. It means when we are immersing a convex lens in a liquid whose refractive index is more than that of the material of the lens, then its nature is changed. Means the convex lens behaves like a concave lens. And if you immerse a concave lens in the liquid whose refractive index is more than that substance, then it behaves like a convex lens. Means the nature is changed. Negative to positive, positive to negative. This minus sign changes the negative to positive, positive to negative. Okay, let's take one example of that. See, all of you have seen a bulb. Means just imagine a bulb. Have a bulb. Say light, it will travel in a straight like this. No change in the path. Clear? Now do one thing in your home itself. Just put some water within the bulb. Take a not working bulb, old one. You can make a hole here, and you can fill with the water. Okay. So here the refractive index and here the refractive index both are same. Okay. Now just fill some water within the bulb. Then what will happen? Here the refractive index of water and here the refractive index of air. So you know that NW is greater than N air, means the surrounding have a lesser refractive index and within the material, within the bulb, the refractive index is more. So it behaves like a convex lens, means the rays are coming, it will be converged. Definitely it converges. It behaves like a convex lens. Okay. Now do one more thing. Put this bulb in a water. Okay. Put this bulb in a beaker which is filled with water. Then what will happen? This behaves like a concave lens now. Outside there is a water and inside there is the air. So what will happen? It behaves like a concave lens. You do its very interesting activity. Okay, take a bulb and see in a air, you will see there is no change in the ray, and when you put in the water, you will see it behaves like a concave lens. Okay, so this is all about to understand. Okay, just if you understand then comment, if you not understand just you ask. Okay, if you ask then the things will be clear. The physics is a subject by discussing more, as not only with me, you discuss with your friend also. Okay, and just see the video again and again. If you have any doubt, then ask. Okay, this is one of the most important formulas. So thank you very much. Thank you for watching.